Ouch. I am going to die. I suspect. Damn it. Hello, everyone, and welcome back. I'm Finacqua, and we are here on the V4 Vanilla server. We are running... There, that's where I want to be. So I think I have to go this way. I'm starting to get a feel for the paths in spawn. It can be a little confusing. There's these high bridges, and then if we look down, there's these paths on the ground. I think the only way the paths go across spawn is right there. There's a little path going that way, back towards the creeper shop and stuff. And then over here, there's like a little bridge over this mountain. And also, you have to go over here to get back to this area. You can see the path kind of goes that way. It's all very sheer cliff and stuff. There's going to be a path going that way, I think. Or no, it was that way, yeah. Duh, because it's already marked out. You can see I actually extended the path that way because we're going to be working right there. Right there. right there today. But first, I want to get rid of some of the stuff in my inventory. And so I'm going over to the sand castle, Biz's Sand Exchange, because I got some dirt, got a couple stacks, and I could use some sand, and I don't really want to go up to a desert or anything, so it's right here. May as well just trade that up. I think it's a one-to-one trade. I haven't read the rules on it, though, yet, so we'll see. That goes down and over, so if we wanted to go to the police station. So yeah, there's like these two paths around spawn. And I'll show you an idea I had for a third set of paths, and potentially something happening with that. So let's go in here. Business Stand Exchange, 414 Inc. Because Biz414 is his name. That's very funny. Instructions. Take your sand, leave your dirt. Simple. All right, bam. Sand. Dirt. Boom. So now I have the sand to make some glass, which is super fantastic. That's nothing. What is that, I wonder? That is a redstone lamp. Oh, okay, that's clever. Alright, bam. Alright, so we got that. Let's go ahead and show you what I was talking about. I believe there's a path over here. So basically, and I don't know if anyone's using this already or what, or who might be interested in helping me with this. But my idea, so we have these levels of spawn, right? We have the mountaintop with the bridges, we have the ground level with these ground level paths. But also, if we come over here, there's a few of these entrances. But basically, there's little caves that somebody's come through and put some cobble stairs on so you can run through them really easy. But that's pretty much it. Like, we can run all around here, and it's a pretty decent cave system. It doesn't go too deep. There goes, this comes up. This is up by the... you know, this area. If we go down, we can actually come out, if I remember where I'm going, right over where we want to be. And you can see it goes, yeah, this should be it. And there's a couple other branches too, so it goes right underneath spawn. It's very cool. It's already lit up, it's already been stared off, so I was thinking maybe we would do this in a stream, maybe get a couple of the other V4Vers on here, and you know, mess it up a bit. Throw in some cobble, put in like some broken down supports, cobwebs, stuff like that. Just make it like a murky old like cave that's been abandoned, like some kind of a storage cellar almost. Add some vines in maybe, I don't know. And maybe we can do something with this area. Put in some like shady little shops, you know, things like that. But something to think about for the future. Today, right, now I'm on some chicken. We're going to be building our enderbucks. And I have everything I'm going to need right here. Ta-da! And I have a little more stuff too. I'm not sure which of this I will need. You know what I probably do need? Some cobble. I need some furnaces. What else? Is there anything else? Should I just dig it out? Or? Got some stone. I'm going to need that. Got some slabs. Yep. Yeah, I think what we'll do is I'm just going to do a final check on this stuff, make sure I have whatever stuff I need. I don't need that. Oh, there we go. I got cobble right there. You know, maybe I'll go back to my base and cook up the sand, just because it's easier and I got more furnaces. And then when I come back, we'll get to building, all right? Okay, so here it is, back in the same place, so it looks a bit different now. I went ahead and terraformed this up a bit. I missed the spot over here. This is going to be the footprint of the build for today. And if I haven't said what we're doing, although I mentioned it before, but for this time, what we're doing is Enderbucks Coffee and Cocoa. So we're going to build ourselves our little spawn coffee shop. And it's going to fit right in here. It's going to have an espresso machine, it's going to have a little seating area. A little pastry case. We'll have some cakes eventually. And I think it's going to look pretty good. I've kind of designed it out in a creative world. So let me go ahead and put all these in. So what we're going to do is in this area, we'll go like this. And these aren't going to stay necessarily. I want to get the walls done first, and then we'll go to the interior, which I think is the cooler part. I think the outside's okay, kind of gets the point across. So it's a cute little coffee shop, that's nice. But I think it's the inside part that I really like. Oh, fun fact. This thing actually goes down to the stronghold. I guess somebody had dug up here when they found it originally, but it's pretty neat. There we go. And we're going to have some monsters spawning here, I suspect. There we go. And just kind of do like that. Just so we don't get anything too crazy coming up on us, ruining our day. We'll go over here as well. Just light this up. Very generally, very dirty, not looking too good. But I just don't want to get creeped, you know? Because creepers, they gonna creep. Unless they don't spawn, and then they can't creep because they're not existing. You know what I'm saying? That is a perfect spot for that. Dunmar! It's here. Hello. All right, so we should be safe for the moment. Let us continue on our way. Okay, so basically, I want to have the door 3 blocks from the side. I'm just looking at my blueprints real quick here. I think it's going to be right here. I think that'll be the door. Because what I'll do. Nope. Actually, I meant to do it there. Yeah, because then with this block, what I want to do is take my black clay, put it there, and not there. Actually, I want to put it there, there. And then below that, we're going to put these guys. We can take this block out now. Take this one too. So like this, same on this side. And this is basically going to be little pillars that go up the side. So these are going to come up 3 blocks more. Two, one, two. Okay, and then on top of that, there's going to be some more stuff, but I don't have that necessarily right now, so I'll wait. Yeah, and then so 3 blocks and then the door. I'm going to have some iron pressure plates because those open up nice and fast. It's like bam, bam, you're in. And then it closes right behind you. So there's no like, did it close? Is it lagging? It's just like, pew, pew, pew. You know what I'm saying? Okay, I do need acacia for the doors, and I don't have any acacia wood right now, so I may check out Eyelad's shrubbery shop. Just popped in to say hey there. Okay there. So we'll wait on that. Talk to you later. Let's go ahead and glass this up. You know what? You know what? No. We'll keep working on the walls. So on this side it's gonna be the same thing. 3 blocks and then this. One, two, three, and then this. And I think that'll be it for windows. I kinda in my design, kinda had it going all the way, but this is fine actually. This as I think I messed it up and this should have been back one more for my design. So this is actually gonna work out. So basically the idea here is this is all gonna be windows, this will be windows up till here, and then we'll have solid wall all along the back. Because there's nothing to look at, obviously. And then we'll just have one little set of windows right here, just so you can peek over at the path that's going to be over there. And that's going to come right to here, because that's 3 blocks, right? Yep. One, two, three. And then two more on these guys. Bam, bam. Okay, yeah, and we'll just continue this all around, and then we'll put in glass. Actually, I'm going to do this here, I think. We'll see how that looks on the. Oh, actually, no, I don't need. Yeah, I will, because it's glass, so I'll need to do that. Because, yeah, we'll be able to see that block, because it's transparent. So, yeah, I want to say thank you guys while I'm doing this for all of the support and all of the views and just the general awesomeness that you guys have been showing lately, the on everything really. The V for Vanilla, you guys are clearly enjoying, so I'm super happy about that. And I'll do walls, so we don't need that. Same there. And all right, let's move the glass. No, this part. And yeah, I'm gonna keep it coming for you. So awesome. Thank you, and continue to enjoy and to comment and all that good stuff. Yeah, that'll be good. And yeah, so basically, oh, I need to do the backs too. I forgot. Basically, what my channel's looking like right now is V for Vanilla. We got Star Maid going on, although there's been some trouble on the server, so basically every time I've been free to record on there, it's been the server's been down or it crashes right when I get on. So Digimaster is working super hard on that. So just if you guys are fans of that series, go over to his channel, say it, give him a big thanks, and tell him it was for me too, because yeesh. I've dealt with server stuff before, and it's not easy. It's not fun. So yeah, thanks to him for doing that, and we'll get more of that out because that had a lot of views on it too. So you guys are clearly interested. Get some glass going now. Finally, what else? What else we got? Well, basically, the other big thing for me is, I'm working on this build because I am a barista. In the real life, that is my job. And I'm starting a new story, in a new story. The store is opening for the first time. It has not previously been open. I think we were doing glass all the way to the doors, but we'll get there eventually. We can just take it out if not. And so yeah, I'm starting the new store tomorrow for me. You guys, well, when you see this, I'll probably already be there, but yeah, it's made me a little anxious, you know? Looking good. I'm starting to see it coming together. And not like, oh my god, I'm gonna do terrible, blah blah blah. Like, no, I know I'm gonna do great, and it's gonna be fun. And I've already met a lot of most of my new coworkers, almost all, maybe all of them. And they're all really cool people, and it's gonna be great. Big change versus my last store, but there's just that whole new thing, you know, where it's how do you explain it? I do need spruce wood. Haha. I can put the floors in right now. Spruce wood. Just go ahead and take all this up. Yeah, it's just like new. Just because it's. Damn it, I broke my shovel. That was a good shovel, too. Oh well, iron shovel ho. Yeah, so it's just left me with, like, these weird, like. Like, yesterday I wanted to record. Here's a perfect example. Yesterday and today, I had off in preparation for the new store before I actually start. So I was like, yeah, tomorrow I can record. It'll be great. I'll get some videos out for you guys. It's because it had been a couple of days. Hello. It had been a couple of days since the last video, so I really wanted to get something up. But every time I sat down, I was just like, oh, I don't know. I don't feel good. I don't feel like it's right. And I just felt like whatever I said or whatever the video that I made, it wouldn't have been good, you know? And that's, I think, what it is. It's just that general kind of anxiety from this new thing that's happening to me. And I just wanted to, you know, say tell somebody, because yesterday I had people going like, "Are you okay? You look really tired," and all this kind of stuff. So I was like, "No, I'm good. What is that? Is there like a fake block there? Let me try and relog real quick. Yeah, there's a block there. What the heck? Ghost block! Super spooky. That was weird. That might have been from when the shovel broke. It thought I had broken that block, and I didn't. Or my game thought it was broken, and the server was like, nope. Yeah, but, yeah, I just, you know, wanted to share that with somebody, because it was something I realized kind of last night, and I was like, "Oh, that's what was going on," because it was just like, I don't know, everything I was doing, it was just feeling wrong, you know. And it's a weird feeling when you're like that, because usually I'm pretty zen, right? I'm a pretty even-tempered, even-keeled kind of guy. So when stuff like that pops up, it's kind of like, okay, something's going on here. And you know, I just wanted to just share that with you guys. If you guys have, you know, stories about that kind of stuff, bye tunnel. I know you're there. Don't worry. It's gonna be the secret of the coffee shop. You know, feel free to share as well, because I like to know that I'm not alone in these strange things. Ooh, that's a little hurting my eyes a little bit because with that pattern. Okay, I was thinking when I was doing this before about doing oak walls all along here, and I still like it for the back and probably for this side, but I'm gonna have the bar over here, and I was thinking I'm gonna have maybe do some dark dark prismarine blocks over here. So we'll see. I only have 5 on me, so it may not be great, but what I'll do first is put in the oak walls, and I have some of these guys too that I can break up. Break out, whatever the word for it is. That is spruce wood, isn't it? Yes, it is. I did not want to do spruce, I want to do oak. There we go, it's a little lighter. So it lightens things up a little bit versus that spruce floor. And, you know, the dark of the black clay. And we're going to get it even brighter, too, once we get to the bar. We're going to have quartz countertop. Almost done this. And then a little glass display case for some pastry, i.e. some cakes. And we'll also have a little bit of iron, and I believe I was going to go with some white wool for a little counter over here. So that's what that looks like. And we're going to have our espresso bar, like our espresso machine, put into this wall. It's actually going to come down this level, I think. I think I'm actually going to bump it up one for my design. So what we'll do is we'll have basically this area right here. And then into here. And this will be the espresso machine. Just like so. So that's going to be that room. And I may need room over here, but I think I might try something else with it. So let's save that, though, because that's the redstone part, and I want to get the design part done before I put the actual redstone in. So for this, I actually need one unit of this guy. Slabs. One unit of slabs. All right, so I'm going to do 2 blocks to walk around, and then 2 blocks for the case, and then we'll start the counter here. 1, 2, 3, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This guy, and then this guy. So we got our nice little countertop right here. And basically what I'm going to have is a little button over here, probably. And you're going to push the button, and then the espresso is going to flow, and then it's going to auto-pour into a glass, and it's just going to shoot out at you, and you're going to drink it, put it right in your face. Actually, we can go ahead and put the glass for this in, too. So what I'm going to do is right here. And then like this. And there we go, that is our pastry case. Oh, you know what? We also need this to be wool. I was gonna go with black. Oh, that's why I need a black wool, aha. See, I'm so clever thinking ahead when I don't even realize it. Bam, bam. All right, so we're gonna put some cakes on there. So that'll be nice and pretty. And yeah, so that's that. And let's go ahead and, you know, what happens if we do like that? How does that look? I like it. You can still kind of grab it if you need a little snack or whatever. These aren't actually going to be for sale. They're actually just going to be for display. If there's a big demand for cake, maybe I will sell that as well. But the big draw here is going to be the espresso. But yeah, I think that's good. I'm actually just looking at it now. I may move it one over the espresso machine, put it here. So basically it's going to shoot out from the middle. So I actually think I like it there better. I'm looking at it and it looks really weird like this. So we'll do like this. Yeah. So that'll be my espresso bar, my espresso machine. And then, okay, let's grab a roof on this bad boy shot. Oh, you know what? No. Well, yes, we'll start working towards that. I'm gonna need some, oh, you know what? What did I say I want to do there? Spruce logs? I don't have any spruce logs. Yeah, I do, spruce logwood. Let me see what I was gonna do here, because I do not remember. Is it like that? I think so. No, you know what? I was going to go with oak. So I need to grab some oak now. Because I forgot that I would need that. Let's go ahead and grab some of these trees, replant them. You know, maybe we'll go right over here. Hello, guys. What's up? Is there a party over here that I was not invited to? Ow. Ow. Jerk. You're supposed to shoot that zombie. Alright. So, yeah. We'll grab this wood. I don't need too much. Just enough to top off those black clay pillars. Ow. Son of a bitch. Stop hitting me with a bone. That's rude. You don't need that. Or that. Or that. I need the wood. Dang it. Am I already picking it up? Am I not picking it up? I'm not picking it up. Get out of here. There we go. Okay. So pick that up. Cool. Let's run over this way. Grab this tree. And we're also going to make room for the saplings, because I do want to replant these. Just go ahead and toss this dirt away, because we already have plenty of that. Any saplings falling over here? Hello, saplings. Nope. Alright, grab this tree too. Hopefully some more will fall. Hello, I hear you. I see you now. Okay, there we go. And this is the night lumberjacking. It's not easy work, but somebody's got to do it. The graveyard shift of the lumberjack. Is there another piece of wood up there or something? Oh, saplings. Oh, all right. I have a ton. Well then. Yeah, we're good. Plenty of saplings. That last one may not grow. I don't remember what the actual box that they need around them is. But that's fine. Okay, so we got this. And we got some stuff to pillar up with. Just like that. And then we're going to need some granite after this as well, which I should have also brought in with me. Brought in with me? Brought with me. Bam, bam. 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 And that's going to go on top of here. And then we're going to have some dark oak. Lots and lots of dark oak. Alright, so let's go ahead and kill the spider. And do I have dark oak on me? Yeah. Do I have dark oak? Please. Please. And I was going to leave this. No, I was going to polish it, so that's fine. Bam, bam, bam. Just put that away. Put that away, away, away. Away, 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 away. Alright, cool. So we're going to need a lot of stairs for this, too. That's the annoying part of this. I do not like stairs. I don't like crafting stairs. Building with stairs is fine. It's the crafting part of them, because you lose so much material. And it's a bow that is now extra. Okay, so let's go back on top. And we'll just go ahead and put these on. Like, no problems. Ha. This tree is probably going to have to go. Oh, I missed. That hurts. Definitely going to have to get back to the regen beacons. And we are planning on doing some wither fights. Hopefully we can get a beacon out this way. Now that we're building out here, Eyelad's building out here. He's doing something over there. Yeah. Okay. And now, let's just take a look. We're going to do these guys one layer back, so like up here. And that's going to go all the way around, I do believe. Even where there's no glass, because the ceiling is going to be half slabs on those lower halves, as far as my schematic is concerned, anyway. So we'll see how that changes in the future. But for now, that's fine, and that'll peek out on the bottom. So it's a kind of nice, it's like a molding, basically, where you only see, like, the bottom half of this block. Alright, so I don't want to fall, per se. Let's just dig my way down here. Cool. Okay, cool. And now we need those stairs, actually, that we were going to go with. So, bam. And we're going to do these ones. Oh, you know what? I'm actually going to do something kind of fun with these ones. So what I'm going to do is start over here. And on this block right there, I'm going to do on the bottom, and I'm going to need to go up. I may have to actually use this as like a proper scaffold. And then on the top, and then on the bottom. So we get this cool little pattern. And on top of this, we're gonna have another slab back here, I think, of dark oak wood. So it's gonna be a nifty little pattern going on. Just gonna add a little bit of interesting shading and such, and depth to the top of the building, which is always good, you know? Yeah, can I do this from this side? Because that would be pretty neat if I could. I'm gonna leave the corners because they're neat enough already. And then oh, I can't do that. Doesn't want me to do that. Okay. Let's go out. Not there. Like these. There we go. That's what I want. And then we'll do like that. Nope. Wrong block. Wrong block. Dang it. Okay. Yep. There we go. And then for this part, we're actually going to do some fanciness with the door. So I'm just going to skip over on this side. Come over here. Come out a couple blocks just because it makes it a little bit easier to place the blocks, the stair blocks, in the right places. That, like that, and then like that. Okay, and I'll leave that until we come back for the door, which I may not do right now. I may actually do that whenever I get those acacia doors. I may just do this whole section. So for now, I think what we'll do is we'll just finish this roof and then call that an episode because it's already getting pretty long. That's not the way we want that. That's not how we do that here. What are we, animals? Bam. And then top and bottom. Cool. Yeah, so let's just grab this side real fast since we're already up here. Before we go ahead and take a look-see-loo about around everything. Go out like this. Will that mess me up? Nope, that's perfect. All right, and this is gonna be fine, I think. We may have to touch it up, but I want to get this. I just want to show you guys basically what we're doing here. So let's actually go down carefully. Oh yeah, look at that pro skill! Whew. I never do that right. I can't believe that actually worked. Okay, so yeah, let's put the no, you know what? We need slabs, so we'll just go and do like this, like this, like this. All right, and then I heard that. This guy, I got things to do, man. Get out of here. Get out of here, jerk. Oh, daytime. That's how you know. Go ahead and we don't need to take those out right now. That's fine. Let's go up here and then so that's on the bottom. So then what I want to do is put up here. Yeah, so that's gonna be like a little cap for these guys. Ouch. I am going to die. I suspect. Damn it. Creeper, why? It's like I call them. It's like I summon these things out of the ether. Ah, man. Ah, jeez. Well, dang. At least we didn't lose too many blocks. Black stained clay, that needed an oak wood, so there we go. Jeez. Jeez, Lewis. Hey, well, look, we got an apple out of that. We're gonna need it at this rate. All right, yeah, and then just cap that off here, and then we'll just do the front side, and I think that's gonna be us for today. Hello, Blaze, thank you. And we'll just go ahead and cover that. I'm not sure if it's gonna need to stay covered or not, but we'll cover it for now. And you know what? I actually want to do this corner too, because I think that's gonna look a little better. Give it a little bit more continuity. Going with the C words that I can't say each episode. Okay, so yeah, if we come down here, this is what the front's gonna look like. This is actually the best way to see it, so let's take this out. I think that's all we have time for this episode. We'll finish this up another time. We spent too much time yammering. I thought that was gonna take faster, but we were taking our time with it. But I think it looks pretty good. Tell me what you guys think. And again, we're not done, but you know, that's, you know, as far as I'm concerned, that's a pretty decent building. That's it. The way I said that. That's a pretty decent building. We're done. Calling it. Don't ruin it by adding more. But yeah, you can kind of see, I think, the skeleton of what we're going with. We've got our espresso machine. We've got our bar. You know, our countertop over here. We're going to have a little retail area here. Some seating. I'm going to put some pictures up on the wall over here. And some cakes. So, you know, it's a pretty decent Enderbox experience, I think. But yeah, let me know if you have any suggestions, especially with these stairs on the roof. I would love to hear what you have to say about that. And yeah, until next time, guys, have a great, awesome day, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye-bye.